straight out to Rob Davidek with WWJ News Radio 950. Rob, what's the latest?
Well, Nancy, investigators out today using divers as well as the evidence technicians out along the riverbank or along the Raisin, the River Raisin in rural Monroe County, looking for any clues that they could find to crack this case. Autopsy being done, as it was mentioned. They are using dental work. They're taking toxicology and whatnot. We're told this hour that that work will not be complete until Saturday morning, possibly at the very earliest.
Well, to me, if they've got dental records, it would be a simple matter of making an identification, Rob. What's the holdup?
Well, I think, again, getting back to just making sure and being positive that, number one, that it's her, but also, you know, the criminal case that's going to move forward from here.
Joining me right now there at the River Raisin, Rupa Mikulaneni. Rupa, what do you see?
Well, Nancy, I am right here on the banks of the River Raisin in Monroe County, where little Nevaeh Buchanan was reportedly found. Her little body was found last night. We're only 500 yards from the area where her body was found. And it's a rural community, farmland everywhere. It's a beautiful little river, actually. And the area is roadblocked with police, so we can't get very close to the crime scene itself. But it's reportedly where little Nevaeh was found, in a shallow gravesite.
Rupa, tell me, is the location where she was buried last night, Rupa, when we broke the story that she had possibly been found, we assumed that the child had been encased in cement and put into the river, the killer obviously hoping that she would go down to the bottom and never come up. But that's not what happened, is it?
No, that's not true. The body was found on the bank of the river, and there was a shallow grave dug and then cement poured on top.
So the killer poured cement onto the child, onto her skin, her face, her body.
That's correct, Nancy.
Matt Zarrell, what more can you tell me?
I know that they're still looking around. They're sifting through dirt, looking through every evidence they can find. They've got divers in the water. They're looking for a sick and disturbed person that did this. They're investigating over 1,000 leads at this point.
With me right now is a very special guest, Guy Bickley. In a primetime exclusive, he is joining us. Mr. Bickley discovered the child's body. Mr. Bickley, thank you for being with us.
You're welcome.
Mr. Bickley, what took you out to the River Raisin yesterday?
Just to have a day of fishing with my father, who was up here visiting for a couple weeks. We just wanted to wet a line and enjoy the day, was all we had in mind.
Mr. Bickley, what happened?
We went down on the banks, and immediately I saw some concrete on the ground off to one side of where we were going to set up to fish. And there were some rocks adjoining the cement. I thought possibly somebody had filled a hole where erosion was starting. I simply did not believe that it was anything more than that at the time. I proceeded to literally sit on the rocks and put my feet on the concrete as a place to sit to fish. Well, my father was over on the other side of the area that we were fishing on. And slowly but surely, I was smelling things and asked him if he smelt it. And he said, yes, I thought there might be a dead fish on the shoreline somewhere close by. Shortly after that, I took a little walk. I didn't see anything, but I still figured it was something on the shoreline down there, wind blowing my way. But through all the traffic of moving and fishing and standing up, I had cracked up the concrete that we had saw laying on the ground there. And at one point, the flies just started getting terrible. And they were landing on me. I was shaking them off. And then I saw them landing on the ground down where the concrete had cracked from me walking about. And I told my dad to look at this. Well, I pushed my foot onto the cracks, and it went down and came right back up as if there was some kind of pressure beneath the concrete. I then proceeded to scrape the little chunks that had cracked off with my toe, and that's when a small area of skin was visible to both myself and my father, And we immediately packed up our gear and moved to the top of the hill and called 911.
Mr. Bickley, did you immediately recognize it as human skin?
I knew that it was skin. Yes, I knew it was skin, not an animal. It was unidentifiable. I didn't know what it was. It knew it was skin.
Mr. Bickley, at that time, were you familiar with the fact that Nevaeh was missing?
Oh, yes, I was. Very much so. Yeah, we'd been following it in the news.
What was your immediate...
My father even...
What was your immediate thought when you saw the skin?
It went to the child, but then denial come in. I didn't want it to be the child. I didn't want to be the one that found the child. I didn't want it to be the child. But I did know in my heart of hearts that it wasn't an animal, that it was somebody. And as it turns out, it was the little girl.